So we are now a full week into the month of April, which means it's time for me to round up all of my March favorites and share them with you. Hey everybody, my name is Paige and you are watching Piece of the Pie Vlogs, or Pop Vlogs for short. If you are already a subscriber, thank you so much for coming on back to check out this video. And if you have not yet subscribed, please consider it. I would truly appreciate it. I talk about all things lifestyle, home, beauty, Disney, and more. But without further ado, here are those March favorites I promised. First category up this month is beauty. I think that I will always have a beauty category because it is something that I really love to just explore and try new things with. So the first product that I'm mentioning, I actually mentioned in my Fresh Spring makeup tutorial, and if you haven't checked that out yet, I will put a link right up here for you to watch that after you're done with this one. But the product is this Almay Skin Perfecting Healthy Biome Makeup. And I actually have it in a couple shades. This is the darker one, 110 Light. And then I also have it in 100 Fair. So combining these two together is a bit better for my skin. Their shade range in this line is not good at all. I mentioned that in my tutorial video. It is not inclusive of women of color or darker skin tones at all. So I really do hope that Almay hears that message and takes that into consideration when they're looking to add more to this line, because it really is an awesome product. It's perfect for springtime, lightweight, fresh and dewy, easy to blend into your skin. And I just want everyone to be able to enjoy products. It's 2021 and there's no reason why we should be leaving any skin tones out of a product line like this. Now, as the weather has been warming up, I've been wearing more skirts and dresses a bit more frequently, so I have to make sure that my skin is looking super hydrated. Obviously, in the wintertime, that is equally as important, but you can kind of get away with hiding things when you're wearing jeans. So I went to Walmart and I saw this product and I was reminded of it because I used to have it quite a long time ago. It is this Jergens Weightless Wet Skin Moisturizer. And I actually got this from my mom many, many Christmases ago because it was on the Allure Best of Beauty list. So she put together these baskets for my sister and I with all of the Best of Beauty winners. Obviously, this is one of them, and I really enjoyed using it, and I just never ended up repurchasing it. So when I saw it at Walmart, I picked it up, and I have fallen in love with this over again. The best thing about this is that it helps me save time in the morning when I'm trying to get ready and get out the door. So the interesting thing about this product is that you actually apply it once you are done showering and before you towel dry. So while your skin is still wet, you put this on your arms, your legs, wherever you need to, then you pat towel dry, step out of the shower, and you're good to go. The nice thing about this is that it's not super heavy, so you're not gonna feel like your skin is kind of melting with lotion. It really does sink right in and it smells really good. I have the coconut scent, and I think there is one more that I can't remember, but this product is awesome. Highly recommend it if you're looking to save a little time in the morning instead of lotioning up after, you know, you've taken your shower, right before you put your clothes on and things get all sticky. This would be a really good product for you to try. Next up is Amazon favorites, and I have a couple of gadgets and gizmos that are quite unique, but I think you're gonna like them. First one up is this Buzz Lightyear looking thing. It totally reminds me of something that would have come off of Buzz Lightyear's spaceship, but it is actually a mini vacuum cleaner. So I picked this up because, if you don't know already, my husband and I have a little puppy dog, Gus. He is about 6 months old now. He's a golden retriever. And as you know, golden retrievers, they shed everywhere. And I'm learning that as a new pet parent, that it is just kind of a battle. I'm now going to have to fight all the time to keep the house super clean because that's just what we want to do. However, what I am most particular about is when Gus climbs up onto my lap when I'm working on my computer, and his fluffy hair just poofs everywhere into the air and it ends up falling on top of my keyboard, and that drives me crazy when my keyboard looks dirty. So that is why I picked this up. This thing is really easy to use, one button, low maintenance. This is where you empty out the canister, it's rechargeable, and it came with this little brush attachment, which is really nice for running across my keyboard because it kind of gets into all those little nooks and crannies in between the keys, and then when I'm done with it, I just take it off. Now, this is also really great for just kind of running out to my car really quickly and vacuuming up the cup holders if there are any crumbs or just little pieces of trash that have fallen in there. So this is a really handy little gadget, little tool, and yeah, I think you should get one. And the second gadget that I think is pretty cool is this Zip Snip tool from the brand Work. Now, I saw this recommended on one of my Amazon pages. It was just something that was like, hey, you should check this out. And it ended up being the perfect tool for us because last month my husband and I purchased a patio set that we love, but when it arrived, it came in the toughest, most sturdy cardboard that you can imagine. And that was great because the product inside, our tables and chairs, were very well protected and there wasn't any damage or scratches or anything like that to the product itself. However, it was very, very difficult to unbox all of our patio set, and it was even more difficult to break those boxes down to put out for our recycling. So when this arrived, this ended up being really, really helpful to break down those boxes. And I'm gonna insert a clip now of my husband, John, using this tool. You can see that he is using the corner of the box and the flaps to kind of run this across. That is because there is a safety on the blade, and obviously that's there so that you don't injure yourself, but it does make it a little bit difficult to wedge that little gap in with the blade and the safety in between the cardboard or whatever it is that you are cutting. So we use the corners and the flaps to kind of get it running and get it started, and then it was smooth sailing from there on out. And you can see that we were able to break down tons of cardboard pretty quickly and with very minimal effort and without using a box cutter, because that worries me sometimes when we're really trying to break down a lot of things. I just worry about injuring our fingers and then Gus getting in the way, and it just kind of makes me a bit nervous. So I'm not sure if you were able to see it in the video, but here is the safety cover on the blade. On and off button is here, and then this you have to toggle as well. It is rechargeable, and I also wanted to mention that on Amazon, they said this would be really good for opening those really tough plastic packages that products sometimes come in. Like, you know, sometimes an SD card will come in those. This is the kind that typically hangs, you know, at Target, and you have to pull it off to get it in your shopping cart. But like, it's sealed all the way around, you're getting your kitchen shears out, you're mangling the product packaging, and it's just a total mess, and you've probably cut your hands in the process. I think that this would be way easier to use with that. I haven't had a product come home yet with that type of packaging since we purchased this, but when I do, I'm definitely gonna grab this, and I'm gonna put it on Instagram and let you guys know how easy it was. So overall, I think this was a pretty great Amazon purchase, and I think it's gonna come in handy many, many times in the future. Now for the home favorites category, I'm gonna insert some footage here and give you a little tour of some little spaces in our home that I started to decorate last month. So I was visiting a lot of local antique shops last month, looking for all kinds of treasures. My style in our home is kind of farmhouse meets cozy cottage, and I love just filling it up with these vintage antique items that are imperfect. They're chippy, maybe a little bit dusty here and there. Sometimes they're perfectly clean and they just have that character to them, but I just love having those pieces. I love that they all have a unique story, and especially a few of them I have picked up from my grandma's basement last month. We love going in her basement, or I love going in her basement with her and just doing a little bit of treasure hunting for some fun finds. And I get to hear a couple of stories from her about where that object came from or how it was used in the past. So I think it's pretty cool to fill our home with those kinds of things. So I can't link all of these products down in the description box, but I wanted to share them with you so that maybe you can get a little bit of style inspiration if you have a similar style in your home. But I just love all of this stuff. I'm really excited to continue to find little treasures here and there throughout the spring and summertime. Again, it's one of my favorite things to do, is just to go to an antique shop on a beautiful day and kind of roam around and see what's out there. Now out back on our patio, we have this really cool potting table that we purchased right before we moved into our new home, which is the home we are currently in. And I have been so excited to step out there here on these warmer days and pot a couple of indoor plants, and then hopefully as the weather becomes more consistently warm, eventually I'd like to plant some more things outside and work on an herb garden. But I just love this little table. I've kind of filled it up with some old terracotta pots, you know, a shovel here and there, a cute little garden sign. It's just a fun little space for me to work on my gardening skills, because I do not have a green thumb, but it is something that I would like to work on and get a little bit better at. I'm getting there. It's just taking a little bit of time. Moving into fashion favorites, I haven't done a whole lot of spring shopping. I'm still kind of getting into that, and I haven't been as excited with some of the clothes that I have seen in stores, so I'm doing a little bit more online shopping right now. However, I did purchase two really comfy t-shirts that I'm super excited to share with you guys. So my sister ended up sending me a TikTok with this shop. It is called Shop Lonnie and Kai, and I immediately went over to Instagram to give them a follow as well. And it was fun because I actually got to vote on one of the designs that I ended up purchasing because she was kind of torn with what to put on the shirt. But this is the design that I got to vote on, and it is for Animal Kingdom. I don't know if you guys can see, but Simba is right underneath that tree of life, and it has the year that Animal Kingdom was established, which is 1998, and now that makes me feel a little bit old. But the other design that I ended up purchasing is this Space Mountain one. This is one of my favorite rides at Disney World. So obviously it has that ride exterior and the year that it was established, 1975. And this is kind of like a light, almost like a denim blue color. But I already know that I'm gonna be wearing these shirts all spring and summer long here around the house, out running errands, and then when we finally get to go on our next Disney trip, these are definitely going to be packed in my suitcase, ready to go for a park day. So definitely give this small shop some love. Check out their link down below in the description box, and you can see all of their fun designs. They have so many with different rides and the different theme parks. So lots to explore on their website, and it's really fun just to have unique Disney apparel, especially if you are a big Disney fan like I am. Now I have one favorite recipe from last month that I am super excited to share, no pun intended, but it is for chicken tortilla soup, and it is the best chicken tortilla soup. It even is better than my favorite one at one of our local restaurants, so I was super excited. There it is again, the pun. So I was really excited when I took a bite of this for the first time, and it was absolutely delicious. There isn't a whole lot to say about this recipe. I'm gonna link it down below for you, and I will also include a few chef's notes because I am not someone who loves a lot of spice in my food. John is the same way. He can eat a little bit more than I can, but I did kind of cut back on some of the spices just a little bit. So if you have a similar taste preference, you might wanna follow my chef's notes along with the recipe the first time you make it. However, if you can take the heat, go ahead, go for the recipe as it is. I know that it's going to be delicious either way you decide to make it. And the final category for today is puppy stuff, because I figured we have a puppy. Other people probably are getting a puppy, have one, or have a dog, so might as well share what we're buying. The first favorite is actually a brand, and it is Bocce's Bakery. So we purchase so many treats from this brand. We love it because really it's just simple 100% ingredients, and it's stuff that, you know, you can actually read on the back of a box and you're not having to Google what the ingredient is. So we feel really good about giving Gus these kinds of treats. These ones, if you can see them, they are really itty bitty. They are teeny tiny trainer treats. So we use these anytime that we're working with Gus on a certain skill. But what I love the most about Bocce's, in addition to their ingredients being really simple, is that they do seasonal and holiday treat packages. So this one Gus got in his Easter basket. It is the spring chicken recipe, which I think is super cute. So this one is just simply chicken, rosemary, and oat flour. Those are the only ingredients in these treats, and these are like little biscuit size. So we usually give Gus one of these now in whole. We used to break them up. Sometimes we do if we really want them to work for something, but I think that these are super cute. You can get these on Chewy.com, or I've ordered straight from the Bocce's Bakery website. Either way you go, you're good. I also posted on my stories last month around St. Patrick's Day because Gus got some St. Patrick's Day themed treats from Bocce's. We got a whole order that we placed, and it came right on time. And so he got these cute little treats called Lucky Bones, and he loved them. So I will put that picture somewhere on the screen right here because he looked pretty stinking cute sitting next to these treats, and he could not wait to dive in. And as the weather has been getting warmer, Gus has been playing outside a whole lot more, which also means he's getting dirtier and therefore needs a bath a little bit more frequently. So I wanted to find a shampoo that we actually liked, because the one that we had previously been using, it smelled like oatmeal, and I bought it because I didn't want to irritate his puppy skin, which I know can be really sensitive, but smelled like oatmeal, and then that combined with wet dog smell is just really not pleasant. So I wanted to find something a little bit better, and we sent him to a professional groomer at the very end of February, and this is what they used, and it smells amazing. It is Nature Specialties Sweet Passion Puppy and Kitten Shampoo. I don't, there are like no smelling notes on this, but it smells so sweet, so good. He almost smells like candy. It's awesome. And I also got the Shea Mora Shea Butter and Argan Oil Conditioner. And this stuff is really great for his coat. Whenever we are done giving him a bath with these two products, his coat looks so shiny, super golden, super sparkly in the sunshine. And I will continue to purchase from this brand. Even maybe when he is no longer a puppy, I might still use this because it smells that good. I found both of these on Amazon. I'm not sure where else you could get them. I think you can get them in larger quantities if you have a bigger dog, but highly recommend these, and I feel really good about putting this stuff on Gus's coat. All right, so I think that does it for all of my March favorites. As always, I will put all the information from this video in the description box down below so that you can find those products and that delicious chicken tortilla soup recipe. And if you give anything a try, definitely drop me a comment. I love to hear from you guys and comment back about my favorites, your favorites, and just have a fun conversation. But thank you so much for watching this video. If you enjoyed it, definitely hit that like button. I would really appreciate it. And I will see you guys next time. Bye.